Good morning, students. In this class, we will be discussing about the need and importance of management accounting as well as the limitations of management accounting. So, starting with the need and importance of management accounting. As we all know that management accounting is an important tool in the hands of management. That means management accounting helps the management to take right decisions at right time. The following are the main advantages of management accounting. First one is proper planning. We all know that management accounting helps in planning. So it assists in the planning through budgetary control, capital budgeting and cost volume profit analysis. Okay, the management take decisions based on the planning. There are certain tools used for planning. They are budgetary control, capital budgeting and cost volume profit analysis. Second one is effective control. Okay, that is the tools and techniques that we know in management accounting will help the management in comparing the actual performance with the planned performance. That means the organization is divided into different departments, and different departments is known as responsibility centers, and the management will give the tools and techniques to these responsibility centers in order to compare the actual performance with the planned performance. Thus it helps in effective control of each department. Next one is increased efficiency. Okay, that means management accounting increase the efficiency of business operation, and it is increase the efficiency of employees too. We have already said that the management will fix the standard. So whether the departments or individuals are keeping up with the standards or not, the difference or reasons or deviations between actual performance and the standard performance is measured. So the employees and the departments always try to achieve this standard which is set by the organization. So in order to achieve the standards, the managers or the departments or employees try to achieve them, so their efficiency is increased. Next point, measurement of performance. Okay, as we all know that management accounting is a tool for evaluating performance. Okay, that is the performance of each department is measured by ratios and tools and techniques of management accounting. So efficiency of departments can be measured with the accounting ratios, various analysis and budgetary control. Next one, maximizing profitability. Okay, we have proper planning and effective control, and increased efficiency will lead to maximizing profitability of the organization. So management accounting helps the management to control the cost of production and efficiency of each individual in the enterprise. So that will be results in reducing cost of production and eliminating various kinds of wastage. Next one, better customer services. The tool and techniques of cost control in management accounting aims to reducing costs. So the cost control technique is always used by the management accounting in order to reduce the cost. So when the cost is reduced, the price also reduced. So all the employees and organizations are made cost conscious, but the quality of product is maintained or improved because quality standards are predetermined. In this way, customers are able to get quality products at cheaper prices. Okay, So, by applying management accounting in an organization, cost control technique is mainly used. When cost control measures are used in a company, it will reduce the cost. So the price of the product also will be decreased, but quality of the product is not compromised. So the customers get the quality products at a cheaper price. What do you mean by cost control? We are controlling the cost of a product, or controlling the process cost of a product, okay, and reducing the wastage. Next point is quick decision making. Management accounting present the information in a simple and purposeful manner, so it facilitate quick decision. If the management accounting is, or management accounting informations are presented in the simplest manner, so the managers or management can take the quick decisions based on the management accounting. Next one, improve standard living of the people. Okay, management accounting can help to improve the consumption level among the people. In this way, it can improve the standard of living of the people. That means we are giving less cost price, less price we will sell our products, so the people will buy more. That means the consumption level of people increases, so that the standard of living of the people also improves. 10th point, economic development. Management accounting can help in maximizing production at minimum cost. That means by cost control, the management accounting can maximize the production and minimize the cost. This brings about the economic development to a country. So when the resources of a country is maximum utilized, it will give the economic development to a country. Next one is limitations of management accounting. Management accounting, as we all know, is a new discipline which is in a developing stage. Because of that, the management accounting has certain limitations, okay, because it is not an exact science. So there will be a lot of limitations which is faced by the management accounting, because it is a new discipline, as well as it is in a developing stage. First one, based on accounting information. Okay, management accounting derives its information from many other disciplines, like as financial accounting, cost accounting, and statistics, etc. So it inherits all the limitations of financial accounting and cost accounting system. So when the management accounting derives informations from other disciplines, it derives the limitations of that accounting disciplines too. Second one, lack of knowledge. The application of management accounting tools and techniques requires the knowledge in various subjects like economics, statistics, management, econometrics, engineering, etc. Those person who prepares the management accounting, he have to familiar with the tools and techniques which are used in the management accounting, and also we already said that the management accounting is a multidisciplinary subject. So when the management accounting, this person who is in the position of management accountant, have the knowledge of statistics, econometrics, and also statistics management and econometrics and engineering subject knowledge. So we all know that a person with lots of knowledge in these areas is very rare, okay. So it is difficult for finding a person who have all knowledge of all these subjects. Third point is not a substitute for management. Okay, management accounting provides a necessary information for decision making, but it is not a decision itself. Okay, we cannot say that management accounting is a decision. No, it is the tool that supports the decision taking of management. Okay, it helps the management to take the proper decision, but it is not a decision. Clear? Management accounting only provides the necessary information for the management to take the decision, but itself not a decision. It only can inform, and also it can prescribe. Okay, it can only inform. Informations are only provided to the management. It does not prescribe solutions. It is simply a tool in the hands of management. So we cannot say that management accounting can replace the management. Next one is personal judgment. Okay, we all know that the management accounting is prepared by the management accountant. So his personal judgment will influence the informations measured in the management account. Okay, when the management accountant interpret or analyze the result, the management accountant use his own personal judgment to derive the information. So his personal judgment will influence the information which is specified in the accounting for management. Next point is costly. Management accounting is a costly process because heavy investment is required for its installation in a company. Hence, it is not suitable for the small enterprises. It specifies that the small enterprises cannot install the accounting for management system in their organization because it needs a heavy investment, or there is a high level of cash flow or cost associated with the installation of accounting for management. So smaller firms cannot afford this cost, so we cannot apply accounting for management or management accounting in a smaller organization. Next point, evolutionary stage. In the beginning we have said that the management accounting has a very recent origin. It is developed during the later half of 20th century. Okay, that is the management accounting is an developing stage. It is a new discipline. It's still developing stage. So as said, as it is in the developing stage, the management accounting faces all types of obstacles and limitations of a new discipline. That means when a discipline is only developing stage, it faces many limitations and obstacles. Same happens in the management accounting too. Next one is resistance. Resistance means we are resisting the implementation of management accounting in our company. That means it is essential to secure the cooperation and support of all workers in the organization for the successful and effective functioning of management accounting system. If you want to implement management accounting system in an organization, you want to ensure the cooperation and support of all workers in the organization, because the successful of the management accounting in an organization is heavily dependent on the cooperation and support of employees or workers in an organization. Okay, if the employees think that this management accounting is implemented in an organization in order to exploit their exploitation, that means if the employees think that the accounting for management is implemented in an organization, in their organization, for exploitation, because to exploit them, they won't support the accounting for management because they strongly believe that the management accounting is implemented in order to exploit them. So they won't allow the management to implement the management accounting system in their organization. Because of that, they will strongly oppose the system. Okay. It is a main limitation which is faced by the many organizations in this era, that is the old employees or old people, that is the people who are in the higher position will have they will be having the problems of adopting the new technology or new system or new tools and techniques to their life is very difficult. So they will always resist this new types of accounting system. Okay, for example, if you are starting to implement a new system to an organization, the people who are not aware of the system will start to resist them. What we have to overcome, how we have to overcome this one is, we can educate them about this, the importance of implementing the new technology or new system to the organization. Next one is wider scope. Management accounting has a wider scope. It includes several subjects, as we all studied about the various disciplines which are implemented in the management accounting. So this will result because of new various disciplines we are using in management accounting will result in inaccuracies and as well as the practical difficulties. That's all about the limitations of management accounting. Next one is major tools and techniques which are used in the management accounting. First one is financial accounting policies. Okay, financial accounting means it is the collection of important information to the management. Financial accounting will provide important information for the management. Every firm has to formulate sound financial policy for collection and utilization of funds. Okay, every firm has to develop a good financial system for collecting the information as well as the utilization of funds. Next one is financial analysis. What is financial analysis? Financial analysis and interpretation means it is an important tool for management accounting. For analysis and interpretation, many techniques are used. Some of the techniques are ratio analysis, trend analysis, cash flow analysis, etc. What is financial analysis? Financial analysis means it is the process of simplifying complex financial data. We are simplifying complex financial data. Okay, thus we can say the financial analysis means it is the process of simplifying complex financial data. But interpretation means explaining the meaning and significance of this simplified data. Okay, we are explaining the meaning and significance of this simplified data. That means when we analyze the data, these analyzed data are to be communicated. So we will only return a short form to convey the information. You can say that analysis and interpretations are also interrelated and complementary to each other, because interpretation is not possible without analysis, and without interpretation, analysis has no meaning. So interpretation begins where the analysis ends. Next one is historical cost accounting. Okay, historical cost accounting means it is recording actual cost after they are incurred. it is also known as sunk cost, etc. Okay, already accrued aayittulla cost record enninaanu nammal historical cost accounting nu parayunnathu. Next one, budgetary control. In budgetary control, expenditures and revenues are predetermined, that is standards are fixed, then actual costs are compared with the budgets. When there is any deviations between budgeted cost and standard cost, there will be deviations, that is there will be difference between actual and budgeted one. So there will be deviations. Then in order to correct this deviation, a corrective actions to be taken to correct the deviations. Next one, standard costing. It is an important technique of cost control. In standard costing, costs are predetermined in the scientific basis. The actual costs are compared with the standards, and any variance occur, it will be analyzed to find the causes of variations. Then action is taken for the removal of unfavorable variance. Sixth one is marginal cost. Under marginal cost, cost is divided into fixed and variable cost. Variable costs are taken for decision making. Marginal cost will be discussed later on. Then decision accounting. Decision making is the process of selecting best alternative from different alternative. There will be a lot of alternatives to be selected, but we are selecting the best alternative among them. The cost of different alternatives are analyzed, and most favorable alternative is analyzed. So when there are lot of alternatives are available, we analyze these alternatives and take the best alternative. This is called decision accounting. Next one is revaluation accounting. That means this method is implemented in an organization to overcome the problem of replacement of fixed asset in the period of rising prices. Okay, revaluation accounting means it is a replacement cost which will be incurred by an organization during the rising prices, that means in the case of inflation. Next one is management information system. Management information system means it is the system that collects data, stores and processes data, and provides information to the managers for planning, controlling and decision making. Okay, management information system means it is the system which are used by the management in order to collect the data, in order to store them and process the data. Management information system. Okay, reversely, it is known as system which is used for taking information to the management. Okay, that is, it provides information to the managers in order to deliver the functions. What are all are the functions of management? Planning, controlling, decision making, organizing, etc. With the development of electronic data processing and computer system, reporting to the management has considerably improved. By if an organization wants to implement the MIS to an organization, previously it is based on the traditional methods are followed, that is books entries are made, but nowadays we are using electronic platform in order to retrieve the data from the system. Next one is responsibility accounting. That means it is the system of control in which the organization is divided into different departments. Each department is known as responsibility centers, and the responsibilities which is related to those departments is assigned to a person, and he will be controlling the cost of product or that department. Next one, other techniques which are used by the management accounting is Accounting for price level changes, differential cost analysis, risk analysis, value analysis are the other techniques which are used in the management accounting. Okay. Next one. Installation of management accounting system. That is the process of implementing management accounting to an organization. These are the preliminary steps which is followed by an organization for the installment of management accounting system in their organization. First one, preparing organization manual. First of all, they will prepare organizational manual. What do you mean by organization manual? Organizational manual means this manual explains the nature and extent of authorities and responsibility of each person in an organization. If a company, while we are implementing the management accounting in an organization, first we will prepare the organization manual. Organizational manual, in organizational manual, we will explain the nature and authority responsibility of each persons of organization. So it also shows the line of communication in an organization. So every organization who is implementing management accounting system have to prepare organizational manual in. Okay. Next one is preparing forms and returns. That means suitable forms, returns should be designed and prepared. These are required for the collection and presentation of information to the managerial needs. For implementing management accounting in an organization, we have to prepare the forms and returns which are related to the managerial needs. Next one, requisite staffing. That is the staffs who are managing management accounting have to be trained and developed. Next one, training of staff means the recruitment and training of necessary staff for training. The next, it is necessary for the organization to staff and also provide training and recruitment for the staff for carrying out various functions of management accounting. Next one is classify accounts and integrating systems. That is proper classification of accounts and data assigning. Suitable cost will ensure simplicity of operations in the management accounting system. That means we are using certain costs for the suitable costs for the classification of accounts and data, and it will simplify the operations of management accounting implementation. Next one, then integration. That there are two terms are associated with the fourth point. First one, classification and codification of data. Classification of codification of data means we are assigning suitable costs for the classification of accounts and data. Integration means management accounting system should be integrated with the existing system of financial accounting and cost accounting, because to avoid the duplication of work and also excessive costs. In order to avoid the duplication of work, the management accounting system to be integrated with the existing system which functions in the organizations like financial accounting and also cost accounting, in order to avoid the duplication of work and also excessive costs. The next one is introducing standard costing techniques. The technique of standard costing should be introduced. This involves setting up of standards and recording actual performance so that the reasons of variations to be ascertained and corrective actions is to be taken. That is, in standard costing, we always put a milestone. that is known as standard, and the actual performance is compared with the standard performance. Any deviations occurs, corrective actions to be taken. Next one is introducing operational research technique. Okay, the business is operating under the changing environment. Every day new ideas or new challenges are developed, so operational research techniques will help to cope up with these changes. So introducing operational research technique in an organization helps the organization to cope up with the changes in a economy. So the installation of management accounting system, that is the process of installing a management accounting system in an organization, involves these steps, because before the installation of management accounting system we have to follow certain steps. In smaller organization, the functions expected from the management accountant can be performed by the chief accountant or a company secretary. The medium to large organization, a full fledged system of management accounting can be installed depending upon the nature and complexity of the business. That means in smaller organization, the management accounting system can be functioned by the management accountant or by a chief accountant or a company secretary. Okay, but in case of large organization, medium to large organization, a full-fledged system of management accounting to be installed based on the nature of business. So in order to install the management accounting system in an organization, the following steps are followed. First one, preparing organizational manual. Organization manual, there is a, it will explain the extent of authority and responsibility of each person in organization, and also it shows the line of communication in an organization. Second point is preparing forms and returns. That means suitable forms are designed for the collection and also presentation of informations required under the management accounting system. This will ensure standardization and also uniformity to the system. Next one is requisite staff, that is the recruitment and training of necessary staff for carrying out the various functions of management accountant. Next one, classifies accounts and integrating the system. First, classifying and qualification of data, that is proper classification of accounts and data are assigning based on the suitable costs. This will simplify the operation of management accounting system. And integration with the existing system, that is management accounting system should be integrated with the existing system of financial accounting and cost accounting to avoid the duplication of work and also excessive cost. Next point is introducing standard costing techniques. In standard costing, we always fix a standard. That is, a new standard is introduced. The setting up of standards and recording actual performance will help the organization to find out the deviations and also in order to take the corrective actions. Next one is setting up of budgetary control system. Budgetary control system to be introduced to the organization to plan the activities of various department and also to improve the performance. Next one is introducing operation research technique. The business operating under the changing environment, in order to cope up with the changes, the organization has to introduce operation research technique. So we will revise what all we have studied so far in this class. First, we have discussed need and importance of management accounting. Then we discussed limitations of management accounting. That is, together we have studied advantages or uses of management accounting, and also the limitations or challenges which are faced by the management accounting implementation. Then What all are the major tools and techniques which are used for management accounting? Then, what is the process used by a organization for implementation of management accounting system in an organization? Okay. I think all are clear with the terms which are discussed so far in this class. Any doubt, please feel free to contact me. That's all for today's class. See you in the next class. Thank you.